What do we have before us? Yes, it's the awesomest Sausagist double set that I have seen come out from AMT via round two. Over 500 parts in this box. You guys have seen me build the big construction bulldozer, the Caterpillar D8, without the name branding on it. You've seen me build this in a video back in May 2018, actually, is when I put it together, when that came out. Now everyone's, you gotta put it on the Lowboy, you gotta get it on the Lowboy. Well, AMT was listening to all you guys and your awesome, nice comments, and they decided to release this as a combo set. In this box is the bulldozer and the Lowboy. Now what I'm gonna do is, I'm not gonna build the bulldozer in this video, but we're gonna see it in the video. What I'm gonna do is, I still have the model I built. It's the exact same kit. I'm going to link to that video down in the description, and at the end of the video, in the closing credits, will be a link and you can watch me build the bulldozer. What we're gonna concentrate on this video is assembling the Lowboy out of its 150 parts total. And then we will take that bulldozer and put it on the Lowboy so you can see how it looks all together. So we're gonna get everything all in one video. We're just gonna do it a little different since I've already built one of the kits in there. Now, first thing we'll look at, of course, when you open that box, is gonna be all the parts for the bulldozer. They've got a chrome tree. We're not gonna go through all the parts because I do it in the other video. You got this giant bag of parts. All right, with the plow in there and everything. You've got the gorgeous tracks which just snap together and line up lovely. They work out perfectly. They're already in silver. And then we've got all the mechanics, the hood, all the other equipment. It's a gorgeous kit of over 300 parts all on its own. And that is in the box with its manual and everything. And then what we're going to look at now and build in this exact video is the Lowboy itself. We've got the, it looks like axles and everything. This is all molded in yellow as well. If you're a fan of minimal painting, this kit is gonna help you out quite a bit. Check out these trees on here. Beautiful molding. We got that front end of the trailer, the upper tongue and everything. This will bolt right up to all the AMT tractors that they sell. So you can decide whether you wanna do it modern or vintage with the hauler for it. We've got a nice bed here with wood grain. We'll get the light to hit that. I'll be painting this and accentuating that with that wood grain on there. We've got cross braces for the trailer. You're gonna go through a lot of styrene glue on this one. We got what looks like braces on the end of the trailer. Details, check out those awesome wheels. Love that period look. We got more wood here. Nice texture, variegated. We got different kinds of like wheel chocks. We got caution flags. We got, looks like, more braces on there. We're going to be able to build this trailer up, weather it a little bit, and then get that nice bulldozer on there. I still have that kit that I built. It's absolutely beautiful. We've got our axles and springs and suspension, brake parts, trailer frames. We got the back of the trailer where all the wheels go through. We got our brake drums here, our wheel backs, more wheels on there. This one has a more of a steel look to it for rigidity, where all three axles, 12 tires total, will be coming through. Let's switch sides on the desk because that's not everything that's in there. We're going to have some clear red parts for the taillights, marker lights on the trailer. We've got a nice chrome tree. Check out all these little tie downs, all done up in chrome. You can dull coat those, put a little wear and tear on them. We've got our wheels here, our outer wheels. If you want to have chrome outer wheels on your trailer, you are all set. If you don't, feel free to paint right over that. We've got a gorgeous set of decals. These are the decals for the entire kit. Three grills for the bulldozer, Universal Construction. You know, they've released numerous kits, the El Camino, the Blazer, all with this Universal Construction logo to tie them together. We got a Michigan Tractor and Machinery Company logos. We got Mid-State Machinery Movers, wide loads, oversized load banner, looks like a fabric banner, pinstriping, license plates, unit callouts, state registrations. We've got it all on that massive water slide sheet. And finally, 12 new style. These are the new mold tires from round two. Excellent tread. These are Firestones. They are lightly pad printed. You can just make it out on there on camera. So you can mount them in or out, whichever way you want. But those they've been using on kits are absolutely beautiful. You got a dozen of these things. All right, so that's the stuff that's in the box. We're gonna get to building this trailer. When I get some sub-assemblies done, I'll be right back. The directions are pretty straightforward to understand. There's nothing really complicated. They're standard AMT fare. You can see everything, how you assemble the entire rear axle assembly, which is right there. And then they have you move on and start doing your framework. And it's just a bunch of cross members that you'll glue to one side of the frame. On each one, let those dry, and then assemble your other side and square everything up. A good thing to invest in when you like to build models that have long frames is just a small modeling square. Get it anywhere, hobby and craft square, just pick it up. The brand names do not matter. Again, I've cut the tie down hooks and the hubs free. What I'm gonna do is give those a matte coating. That'll bring them down, give them a black wash. They'll look like a little bit of used steel. We'll be able to glue those onto the wheels and to the sides of the trailer. We got the axle assembly all set up. It's a nice assembly. Has all the air brake assemblies all within it. It's got your nice springs, got the mounts for the bottom of the trailer, and it squares itself up as you assemble it. For the most part, always double check. If you have a builder's board like mine, those help a lot, using those squares or just any small piece. You can get building mats any size you want. You know, you don't need to have a giant one like I have. So they always help with trailers and any other kind of thing like so. Got the flags cut free. Definitely going to be putting those on the trailer. So we're going to be painting those up. Got the wheels glued together. I'm not doing mine in chrome. So I sanded off the chrome on the ends and butt joined them with model glue and the brake drums. We'll get those all painted up together as one unit over on the paint booth area. Now, you can use the trailer platform to square it up. You could also paint it all together and then hand paint your wood or whatever. But I left a lot of parts separate just to make things fit in my booth so I can paint them. The deck here and the upper deck will help you square your entire assembly up every time. Just keep placing it in. It should literally press and be flat with the sides when you press it down on there. We'll attach this at the end with some super glue. I always use dollar store super glue from the Dollar Tree. Super easy. A little bit of model glue. I like Bondine, Plastruct Bondine. Places like Model Roundup carry that for you. So I like to press those in, make sure everything is squared up. We'll take that off, set that. You can see the wood here, the metal. What I can do is I can primer this, spray this back half, hand brush the front half as wood. We'll be fine. Same with the upper deck here. That's a nice wood plate there. So the bottom we can always leave as if it's metal where it's bolted in. We can leave that whatever color we're going to paint the trailer. And we'll hand paint and weather the top piece. Now you can see our assembly here. Beautiful frame going on all the way from front to back to the beaver tail. All the way in the back end. I did not completely attach my two halves because they do press together nicely, will join nicely with super glue at the end, but I'll pull it in part. Now we can get it painted. We've got our extensions around the wheels back here, our axle assembly. See all your frame cross members have these little tabs? Our axle assembly will just lock right into that, glue in. We'll have it when we're all done, but I want to paint and detail that separate. Got our beaver tail hanging off the back where it comes down at an angle. That was all assembled with model glue and super glue to hold it in while the model glue dried. Same with the front. In fact, you could even see some of the cloudiness where I would put super glue in right after model glue just to sort of tack weld it in place. We got our gajillion cross members. I like to label them with magic marker. This will all get covered up with primer anyways, but it helps when you're assembling it. Plus, the trailer is labeled itself. I don't know if you can see in there, but it says like F, 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 G, H, and so forth on the inside of the trailer, right where the cross member goes. So they do help you assemble it, get it all straightened out, and like I said, continue to use your deck plates to square everything up. They should drop in. Since this piece here is the steel of the trailer, I also glued it into place right now just to make the trailer more rigid and make sure that I was putting everything in perfectly straight. So that is it. Like I said, 90 minutes, 2 hours, whatever, get you to line everything up. Now I'm going to go hit the paint area. It's going to be a very generic paint job because these are construction trailers. They're not usually custom painted. I'll see you over there.
We'll be right back.
The nice thing about these trailers is they're always quick builds, no matter whether I build a box van, a flatbed. I've built all different types of trailers on the show, and they are always nice to work on. You can check out that sweet axle system back there. When I put the white letters on the outside, he takes a little more pride in his flatbed. I scuffed up the wheels a little bit here and there, just so you can kind of see that they're a little banged up on there, but they do look nice. They can freewheel if you want. I got two freewheeling. I got one glued in place, so the trailer never goes anywhere. I did dirty it up a little bit. Every trailer gets used, so I did scrape it up a tad bit. That is ready. That on this trailer will just flip over and glue right into place, and it fits perfectly where there's no issues at all. Underneath the trailer itself, I just did a little bit of dirtying up. I don't want to completely shred this trailer. The bed always gets banged up and dirtied up, and oil stains. I mean, if you're going to use it, it's going to be used. You're going to see where I lightened up the wood on the sides, where the tracks are always scratching it and exposing fresh wood, where they're dragging things off the top lid. And then I've got just the surface rust on the bottom, some oil stains, and a lot of scratching on the back where things drive up and over onto the back of the trailer. And it just looks wonderful. The sides are just a little scuffed up, but left them alone. I used Tamiya clears to tint the lights on all mine. Instead of using the plastic lights, you can always use these. There's nothing wrong with them at all. I just find it easier for me to just use some silver paint and then put the Tamiya clear over the top, and I'm done. We got the strap hooks that'll be glued on the side. Those are still left to go. You see how nice that looks when you flat coat the chrome, then use a black wash over it. They look really nice and realistic on the side. Got the flags painted up. Just need to detail the actual flag pole, the flag staff, and then drill some holes and stick it in the trailer wherever we want to position it on here. So that is just about it. On the trailer, I have to attach my reflectors. And if you so choose, you can use the larger reflective black and yellow tape on the back, or you can use, they include a piece here and some extra side pieces to put on there. We've got our wide load and oversized load emblems for the Caterpillar itself. The Caterpillar, of course, was built in that other video that I linked to. When I come back, the trailer will be done. I'll have the Caterpillar on it. We can look at both together. Well, it barely fits on the bench. The thing is gigantic. Each one of these squares is an inch, so you can pause the film to see how long and wide the kit is. It is gigantic. I'm surprised the turntable can spin it. We're bringing back that Caterpillar D8. This is the exact kit that's in the box. Now combined with the Lowboy trailer, you can see the work I did on the Lowboy. I tried to chip and peel some of the decals after application so that they look like they've been peeled and reapplied. We got our hooks on there. I added some nice scroll work like a lot of the trailer companies do. I drilled holes in the very far back where they can drop their flags in, and I used some masking tape, little strips, to tape the oversized load decal on the front of the blade there, so when cars are coming up behind it, they can see that it's a lot wider than the trailer is. Everything looks awesome. You can see it fits the trailer nicely. If you leave this hook so that you can raise it and lower it, you can always lift it up, put it on the upper deck, and bring that more forward. But I've got it sitting farther back, so there's more weight on those axles back there like they would in real life. So, beautiful kit. Pretty easy to assemble. The trailer is extremely easy to assemble. The Caterpillar is not hard to assemble. It just takes a lot of time. So they are beautiful. I'm going to link to that Caterpillar build in the description and at the end of the video where they allow me to put other videos on there, so you can see this whole thing come together and get weathered. I highly recommend picking up this set if you're out there looking for it. What could go better than the two together? You're going to save a lot of money by buying them. I will also link to the combo kit, that round two sent, in the description so that you can find that right away and get your copy. Stuff like this sells out really quick, so even if you're not at the skill level, which I think anyone that has built probably half a dozen cars that glue together could easily get this entire kit, the trailer, without any problems. The Caterpillar, just a little more work, a little more fiddly work, and it goes together super, super sweet. So you can see what you're gonna have is this giant combo. You can attach it to any of the AMT 125th scale, 124th scale trucks on the front end. Looks real nice on the back there. And you're going to have yourself one heck of a kit. Now, I didn't rust and crust and destroy this one. I made the Caterpillar quite dirty because they get absolutely filthy. The trailer definitely looks like a trailer that's got a few years on it, but it's not anywhere near its useful life being over. It's still shiny blue. It's got some scratches. The deck of these things always gets beaten up quite a bit, and they replace that whenever they need to. The steel on the back has oil drips and scrapes and surface rust, but otherwise it looks just fine. Got those reflectors on the back, got the little Michigan license plate on the back, and I'm really glad that they have this as a combo kit because it is just so sweet. I will have pictures at the end, more close up, more detail than we can get on a turntable in the middle of the desk. I will see all of you at the next review, and remember, build for you, have fun. These are your models, build them how you want to see them. Take care.